Hey there, fellow travelers. Mark here with Walter's World. Today we're in rainy Colonia, Uruguay. And what we're going to talk about today are some things you should know before you come to Colonia, because it does make a really easy, great day trip from Buenos Aires. Or if you're going from Montevideo, it's only like almost 3 hours on a bus, so it's not that bad to get to, and it is well worth checking out because this is a UNESCO World Heritage Site city. The historic center is UNESCO and it is gorgeous and it's cool to check out. So here are the kind of the five kind of main areas I want you to know, or five main things I would want you to know, or I'd want someone to know when they're going to come here. The first thing is you got the sites, right? You have the historic center. And when you're coming in, if you're taking the bus or you're taking the ferry in from Buenos Aires or the bus from Montevideo, they actually drop you off at the same, basically the same spot. And you walk into town and you'll see the gate to the city that's still there. And you can see some remnants of the wall that's there you can walk on and stuff. You have that. And then you come into the old town and it's all, you know, cobblestones, broken stone streets. So one, if it's raining like this, it can be a little slick. And two, it is rather bumpy, so watch your footing when you're walking around. But the architecture and the colonial buildings that are there are just gorgeous to walk through and enjoy. And the thing is, there's a lot of little museums around the historic center. Since the Portuguese were here, there's a Portuguese museum. There's the Azulejos, or the blue tile museum, the Portuguese tile. There's a museum for that. There's a museum for the indigenous people. There's a Spanish museum that's here. There's a municipal museum. There's all these little museums you can check out to get some cultural side of things, aside from the fun stuff to do when you come to this town, okay? The one thing that you really want to do that most people come and see, they say, I have to do this when I come here, is you're going to see the faro, you're going to see the lighthouse. And you can actually walk up the lighthouse to get a view of the city. Now, if you got little kids, they can't go up for safety reasons, so that kind of sucks. But do know there's a plaza right by the lighthouse, which has an ice cream place. You can have some ice cream and you can enjoy and kick the soccer ball around and things like that. And the thing is, when you're here, you're going to be wandering around, so you can walk along the waterfront, because it's a point. When you're here in Colonia, you can walk around the waterfront, which is really pretty. You can see the Rio de la Plata. You can see that. You can walk through the town. There's a basilica on the hill you can go into. I mean, it's kind of plain inside, but it is a nice little place to check out when you are here. And it just really is. It's kind of like, you know, a few blocks by six block by six block, or eight block by eight block, you know, kind of historic center, which is just really, really gorgeous. And the thing is the second thing I want you to know is the tourism infrastructure here is really good. I mean, this city is obviously knows that it's for tourists, and it knows that it gets a lot of people from Buenos Aires coming over here for the weekends and things like that. So there's a lot of hotels, there's a lot of posadas you can stay at, and that's cool. I will say, if you're going to be coming during busy season, so like in the summer times or busy holiday weekends, or tourism week or Easter week, Holy Week, here in Uruguay, know that you need to book your hotel accommodations well in advance, because it's going to be tough to find places. Also, because there's so much tourism, make sure if you're going to be coming from Buenos Aires, you book your boat early before you come, because they do sell out, okay? But the thing is the infrastructure, with a lot of really good restaurants, there's bars around here, there's places for you to have fun and stuff and to enjoy. And the thing is, there's tourist information at the harbor, okay? There's tourist information in town, so you'll be fine. So that's really kind of cool. And I guess for my kind of infrastructure stuff, you probably want to know what you want to eat when you come here. One, you have chivito, which is the Uruguayan steak sandwich. I mean, this thing is awesome. Bread, steak, lettuce, tomato. Then they take the cheese, wrap it in ham, cook that, and then they put, you know, an egg on top and mayo and stuff. Oh, it's so good. And if you don't want the carbs, you don't want the bread, well, they can make it al plato, chivito al plato, which is basically take off the bread and put it on top of potatoes. So there is that. I would definitely have the tannet wine. That's the Uruguayan wine, okay? You don't see it a lot of places outside of Uruguay, because they don't produce a lot of it. So when you're here, definitely enjoy that. That's really nice. If you're any kind of sweets, they have dulce de leche, which is kind of like a caramel kind of thing. That's really good too. So have those things. And you'll see people with their mate, the herb mate stuff to drink when you're here. So you'll see that. People have that all the time. But it's really cool, because they do have this nice tourism infrastructure. And what's cool is part of that is, since they know all these tourists come in, the restaurants, their menus are in English, they're in Spanish, they're in Portuguese. The people will speak some English around here if you need a little help. And that's what's really nice about it, okay? Because in other parts of Uruguay, you don't find a lot of English, but here you find enough that, oh, hey, that's helpful. And the menus are set up for that. Now, third thing I want to talk about when you come here is actually how you're gonna pay for things. Well, in Uruguay, they have the Uruguayan peso, so of course you can pay with that. But since they have so many tourists from Argentina, from Brazil, coming here, you actually can pay in Uruguayan peso, you can pay in the US dollar. I've seen places where you can pay with the Argentine peso. I've seen places where you can spend with the Brazilian real. Heck, I saw places where you could pay with euros. But usually I would say the de facto non-Uruguayan peso currency would be the US dollar. And the thing is that sometimes your restaurants will actually give you your bill in Uruguayan pesos and in dollars if you want to pay that way. So you do have that. And what will happen is they might tell you the price in Uruguayan pesos. You say, hey, can I pay in dollars? They'll tell like divide by 30 or whatever the closest exchange rate is at the time. For being a tourist place, they're very fair and they're not ripping people off, which I thought was really, really nice. Okay, so that is kind of cool. Another thing about the money stuff, the ATMs, there are ATMs at the banks around town, but they're inside the banks. So you have to swipe your card to get in, or some of them are only open during bank hours. So make sure you have that, because I would have some cash because you want to buy some trinkets and stuff like that, or tip. It's always nice to tip in the Uruguayan pesos, but people take dollars, no problem. So you can do that. And you might want to know is, what do I spend my money on when I'm here? Well, aside from the wine and the beef when you are here, the asado is really good, the beef and stuff. Is you want to look at, there's a lot of leather goods, a lot of wool goods, ceramics, stuff like that. I know Jocelyn's got a really cool pair of leather boots when she was here. My mom got a couple cool sweaters, a ceramic bowl to take home. So there are some cool things to buy when you do come here. So maybe leave an extra room in your day pack or your suitcase when you're coming here to buy some stuff when you are here. Now, the fourth thing I want to talk about is what you're really going to do when you are here. And I just want you to know, this is a very much a chill out and relax town. I mean, things don't get started very early, okay? Dinner time, some restaurants might not open till 8 o'clock at night. And so you're really much a laid back kind of thing, which is cool, because when you walk through the historic part of town, you're like, yeah, I can totally chill out here. I could sit at this cafe and have some wine, or have a Patricia, one of the local beers here, and have that. I mean, it's cool and it's really relaxed, and you need to have patience when you are here, okay? And if you are here in the summer, I mean, I'm here in their winter, okay? Oh, that's something you probably should know is Uruguay's got flip seasons from the US. So summer is December, January, February, March, whereas winter is June, July, August. Well, I'm here in their winter months, and it does get a little chilly here if you're coming here in June, July, things like that, because I know a lot of Americans and Canadians will actually fly down to Buenos Aires and during our summer holidays in the US, but it'll be winter here. So make sure you bring some layers, okay? I'm gonna tell you that one now. But if you come in the summer, there's some like river beaches you can go to, which is nice. There's stuff outdoors you can do, so it is really cool, okay? And what's really nice though is this actually is a really safe town. In Uruguay in general, it's like the safest country in South America, Central America, probably in the Americas outside of like Canada or something like that. So you are really safe when you are here. So that's a nice thing. And since they like to protect their tourists, it's even safer for you when you are here. But of course, don't be silly. Don't leave stuff in your car if you have one, and don't like flash your money just like you would anywhere in the world. But here you feel a lot safer. So it's really nice with the kids and stuff, because they could play in the park and I could talk over here and we could get ice cream. They go shopping. It was a really fantastic experience. Okay. And the last thing I want to talk about is actually transportation. So if you're going to be coming here to Colonia from Tres Cruces, in Montevideo, that's the main bus station in Montevideo, it's going to take you about 3 hours. Okay, so they say 2 hours and 50 minutes. Let's just say 3 hours, okay? But when you're buying your bus ticket, make sure you look at duración, or duration, because there are some that take longer than that 3 hours to get here. So do have a heads up for that one. And if you're coming from other parts of Uruguay, you might have to go through Tres Cruces anyway to get here. So just have a heads up. And then if you're going to be coming from Argentina, well, there's the Buquebus and there's SeaCat. There's a bunch of ferries that'll come over from Buenos Aires. And I know online everyone says, oh, it's an easy 50-minute ride. Look, maybe the boat is moving for 50 minutes, but our boat left at 11 o'clock and we actually got out of the terminal here at 12:47. Okay, so it's not just a simple 50-minute thing. It's gonna take you a couple hours, because remember, you have to go through customs in Argentina. And when you're in Argentina coming this way, you do customs for Argentina and Uruguay there. So when you do get off the boat here, you just walk off into the city, which is really cool. And if you're going back to Buenos Aires, they do all that stuff on this side, okay? So you need to be there a little earlier to get your bus to go there, okay? Because you do need time for that, all right? Now, other things I want to say is, if you want to get around town, one of the fun things I saw is you can actually rent a golf cart when you come here. You'll see a bunch of thrifty signs or whatever signs, you know, rental signs that are renting out golf carts. They might look like old-fashioned cars, or just like, you know, like, I don't know, Apocalypse Now versions, end of the world golf carts. They have fun themes with them and stuff, but you can rent this golf cart to go around, and that is a nice thing to do, just because there are some hills, and maybe if you're staying a little bit farther off, it's easier to get downtown or get to the historic center with them. So I saw a lot of people getting those. We stayed kind of in the heart of the old town, so we didn't have to do that. It would have been a fun thing to do. So I hope this helps you know a bit more about what you should know before you come to Colonia, whether it's a day trip from Buenos Aires or you're staying here for a few nights. I'm sorry that I'm filming here on my third day with rain. I should have filmed when it wasn't raining, but hey, that's how it is when we travel. It happens, and it's still a wonderful place to be. So if you want to learn more things about coming to Uruguay, the don'ts of Uruguay, things you should know about in general when you come to Uruguay, maybe you want to know something about Buenos Aires because you're going there too, we have all that on our website at waltersworld.com. And we're also on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and any kind of video about travel that you're thinking about, a place you want to go, just search on YouTube. Put YouTube, you know, put the destination in Walter's World up there. If we got videos, I'm sure it'll pop up on there. So have a great time here in Uruguay. I wish you all the best. I'm going to try to dry off here and enjoy some more time here in Uruguay. Bye from Colonia.